On June 10th, 1864, Maximilian I was crowned Emperor of Mexico. Max, as we're gonna call him, was the younger brother of the Austrian Emperor and had arrived in Mexico only 12 days earlier. Now he was in charge of the entire country, all because the French had conquered Mexico and put him on the throne. What Max didn't know was that he was in way over his head. Today, the thought of Mexico having an emperor is kind of strange, but believe it or not, when Mexico won their independence from Spain, they actually appointed one, but then quickly changed their minds and became a republic, starting a decade-long struggle between liberals who wanted a democracy and conservatives who wanted an authoritarian state. Finally, in 1861, the liberals came out on top and started turning the country into a federal republic with constitutional human rights and democracy. All was well, except that the country was basically in ruins after all the war, and because of destroyed foreign property, it was also deeply in debt to European powers, especially the French, who had shown up with their gunboats and made sure that Mexico promised to pay back every single coin. However, now the liberal president Benito Juarez made it pretty clear that debt repayment wouldn't be a priority. Enter Napoleon. No, not that Napoleon. His nephew, Napoleon III. Like his uncle, he was Emperor of France, and like his uncle, he wanted to conquer the world. And now, he had the perfect pretext to invade Mexico. Not only could Napoleon get his money back, he could set up a Mexican puppet state that would serve as his foothold into the Americas, and give him access to the region's resources. And not to mention, it was pretty good timing. Normally, any invasion of Mexico would be hindered by the Monroe Doctrine, or basically, America saying, "Don't you dare colonize South America." However, at the moment, America was kind of in the middle of a civil war. So, France allied themselves with the Mexican conservatives, who also wanted to return to the monarchy system, and invaded Mexico, quickly capturing large parts of the country, leaving the liberal government in control of only a few areas in the north and south. The Second Mexican Empire was proclaimed, and the post of emperor was offered to Max. Being Austrian, he was at first glance a pretty strange choice, but believe it or not, Max actually did have a claim. Back in the day, his family, the Habsburgs, had married into the throne of Spain and ruled the empire for generations. The Spanish line of his family was now extinct, but the fact that he carried their name made Max's claim as good as any man in Europe. The French insisted that the Mexicans would welcome his rule after years of instability, but Max only accepted under the condition that they hold a referendum first. So, the French held one, and it somehow produced a positive result. While the war was still raging in many areas of the country, Max and his wife, Charlotte, were brought to Mexico and installed into a magnificent castle on a hill outside the Mexican capital. The French promised that they would stay and help stomp out any resistance. The Mexicans would surely accept their new sovereign. Eventually, to everyone's surprise, Max turned out to be not all that different from the government he had replaced. He wanted a constitutional monarchy that shared power with a democratically elected Congress and kept in place all the reforms made by the liberals, even enacting some of his own. Max and Charlotte seemed dedicated to their new roles. The two of them poured their heart and soul into winning the love of their adoptive country, praising, adopting, and promoting everything Mexican. They hosted parties for the rich and used the profits to help the poor. Max came to view himself as a protector of the common people, alienating some of his conservative supporters. At the same time, the liberals were not going to accept him, as he was a foreign monarch imposed on them by force. Max tried to reach out to them and even offered Benito Juarez the position of prime minister in return for allegiance to the crown, but to no avail. A few years went by and the liberals still refused to give up. Before they knew it, America emerged from the Civil War and started pressuring the French to get out of Mexico. An American intervention looked more likely by the day. The royalists were getting desperate, and in 1865, Max made a mistake, imposing the death penalty on anyone convicted of armed resistance. This only strengthened the will of the rebels. Pretty soon, the French decided to end their little Mexican experiment, but Max refused to leave with them. He still believed that he had the support of the people and didn't want to abandon his followers, who all assured him that they could still win. Charlotte traveled to Europe to try and win support for her husband, but her efforts would be in vain. As the liberals began taking back more and more of the country, Max withdrew with his loyalists to a town where they came under siege. The emperor personally led his men from the front, but in the end, he was betrayed by an officer who accepted a bribe to open the gate. Emperor Maximilian was captured and sentenced to death. Despite appeals for clemency from European monarchs and some people in the liberal faction, President Juarez insisted that his sentence be carried out to show the world that Mexico would never accept a foreign monarch. Only 3 years and 9 days after his coronation as emperor, Maximilian was executed along with two of his loyal generals. His last words were in Spanish, saying, "I forgive everyone, and I ask everyone to forgive me. May my blood, which is about to be shed, be for the good of the country. Long live the independent Mexico." In the end, the misled Maximilian died a death worthy of a major Hollywood production. His body was eventually recovered by the very same ship that brought him to Mexico, and he was buried in the tomb of his ancestors in Vienna.